Nice guys are afraid of conflict. This is why they finish last. This is why they're scared to create tension. Women need tension in order to be attracted. So let's talk about tension. Let's talk about the nice guy, most importantly. Now, the nice guy, his whole plight is that he's being nice and people pleasing so that he doesn't have to fear abandonment. So he avoids all tension. He avoids all conflict, especially male and female conflict, family conflict, conflict amongst coworkers, so that he doesn't have to risk being abandoned. That's the core root of the nice guy. Now, when nice guys go on dates with girls, the dates are usually boring, they're not fun. He takes the girl home, she stops talking to him after a while because there's no tension being created, there's no fun being had, and it's pretty just boring and mundane. He goes home, he's frustrated because he's not getting his needs met. He's afraid to express his needs because his needs could create conflict. If he were to tell a woman that he wanted sex, or that he just wanted a one-night stand, or that if he just wanted to hook up, or he didn't want anything serious, but just wanted to fool around, that would create conflict. And again, the nice guy, his whole plight is that he wants to avoid conflict to avoid potential abandonment. Now let's look at the polar opposite of that. Think about the bad boy, right? Think about the asshole who doesn't give a damn or a fuck what anybody says about him. He doesn't care who he offends. He's just himself truly through and through. And people love that guy. They gravitate towards that guy. They're constantly wanting to be around that guy. They're constantly gossiping and talking about that guy. Whereas the nice guy, nobody talks about the nice guy. Nobody really cares to talk about the nice guy once they leave him or don't hang out with him. Nobody ever remembers him. But the asshole and the bad boy, oh yes, people do remember him, right? And they're constantly talking about him. So for the nice guy, this causes constant frustration with dating because they're not getting their needs met. And a part of that reason is they're not okay with having needs. They're not okay with expressing their needs, especially sexual needs. So if they can't even come to terms with the fact that they have sexual needs themselves, they're never going to get to a place where they can actually express it with other people. Here's the thing. That's what turns women on. If done right, it will turn women on. Now, in order for that to work for a nice guy has to dive deeper into himself. What is he like? A lot of guys don't know what they like. A lot of guys are constant people pleasing, right? They know what others like, they know how to keep people pleased, but they don't know how to keep themselves pleased. They actually think that suppressing themselves is actually what keeps them pleased, and that's really not true, because when they see people living a bigger life, they envy those people, they become jealous, and that's how you know they're not really free. I had a date one time, I remember this, and I remember this for me because I had a lot of nice guys I was running, and I remember this date. This is one that really set it off for me, and I went out on a date with this girl, awesome girl, we're having ramen, and at the end of the day, I remember at the end of the ramen date, we were sitting there at the table and paid the bill, and she was sitting there and she was like, so what are we gonna do next? And I remember thinking to myself, like, what I would normally do is go out and take her for a night walk and just hang out with her and probably just take her back home and I'll go back home. But tonight I was just like, I'm gonna risk it because I'm not worried about losing this girl. I'm not worried about being abandoned by this girl. And so I look right over at her and butterflies in my stomach and turn on in my penis. I said, I wanna take you home. And she looked at me, kind of testing me to see if I was gonna follow that with guilt or shame or something like that. But I didn't waver, I didn't budge. And she was like, okay. So she grabbed her purse, we got up and we went to my house. And I remember that day for sure, it was like a turning point for me because I said, wow, I thought that was gonna go so bad. I thought she was gonna take water, throw it at me, make cause a scene, pull away and be very dramatic. I didn't know what the fuck was gonna happen, but I didn't think that was gonna happen. And so what it did was it kind of imprinted a memory in my brain or reference experience to how these things could go. And so following that and on my dates, I would always be just very honest about what I was feeling, especially if it was something sexual. And I started to realize that girls will giggle and laugh and be playful, but also they'll challenge you. But if you don't waver in it, they'll relax and become playful. And maybe they don't want sex that day or that night, but they won't cause a scene. They won't make a big deal out of it. They may even hit you up later or the next date and it'll happen. So for all my nice guys who are watching the channel, which I know there are a lot of, because I was one of these nice guys when I first started watching this channel as well, it gets better when you start to learn what you like and start to express it. So I will recommend taking a risk. Go out there and really expose yourself to rejection and abandonment, because at the core root, that's what we fear the most. Now, the more you can go out there and expose yourself to rejection and abandonment using the high exercises we give you guys, just going out and saying hi to about 100 people a day, or going out and doing indirect openers, or even going out and giving a girl a direct compliment, right? Use those to stir up stuff in your nervous system. Because the more stuff that comes to the surface, the more stuff that you actually have to work with. And in doing that, you'll see that your stories around women, or your stories around abandonment and fear have been keeping you trapped. And it's not even that big of a deal, because abandonment is just a feeling. It's not an actual thing that's going to kill you. So I want you guys to get out there. I want you guys to become better at this, because once you do become better at this, you start to see what's on the other side of the fear, which is very fruitful and very abundant. Sex, women, fun, whatever it is you're looking for, right? Get out there and have some fun, have some experiences. So put in the comments if this is kind of, this informational video is helping you out at all. Put in the comments what you need help with in terms of getting over your nice guy syndrome, or getting over the fear of abandonment or taking risk. Also pick up Dr. Glover's book, No More Mr. Nice Guy. That was a really great book, and that was actually standard reading for all the workshops that we teach her. Hit the like button, subscribe if you enjoy our videos and you want more content from us on the topic especially. And remember guys, only the confident really live. Peace.